something was drastically wrong with the system. The system was breaking down.
It's pretty frustrating, disheartening.
The system they are talking about is Congress. Maryland's crab industry has relied on what is called the H-2B program for many years. That gives employers permission to hire temporary non-immigrants to work in non-agricultural jobs. The problem is, that system wasn't meeting the demands of potential employers.
The cap first rose its ugly head in 2005.
They put a 66,000 total visa cap for the entire country. How anybody arrived at that number, I have never ever heard an explanation for it.
This cap acts as a short-term fix and does not help labor workers, especially during the critical crab season, which is vital to Maryland's economy.
Local seafood businesses here in Hooper's Island are continuing to shut down, including the one behind me, W.T. Roark, that is for sale. Now, this is going to continue to progress and happen unless they're willing to get the labor and spend $20 million of these. And that could cost Maryland's economy approximately $141 million.
According to the Chesapeake Bay Seafood Industries Association, this could lead to a loss of between 846 and 1,257 American jobs. And the association says without a better solution, there will be a $67 million drop in crab processing industry sales and $29 million cuts in crabber and waterman's income. But Maryland Representative Dutch Ruppersberger says Marylanders should remain optimistic.
Basically, would allow, if you've worked in this period, you will qualify and eventually will become a law that you will not need to have the waivers anymore.
But optimism does not come without anxiety.
It's just become the most important thing in my life right now.
And although it's exhausting, people on Hooper's Island say they aren't going down without a fight.
It's tiring, very tiring, and but we're still fighting for these small family operated businesses, independent businesses, food manufacturers.
Reporting live from Hooper's Island, I'm Jack White, CNS TV News.